We live by our values, adhering to the highest standards for purity and kashrut. Out here on the farm, we stand firm in our beliefs, so you can rest easy. Belief, freshly frozen produce, under the strict hashgacha of the Badatz Yerushalayim.
There is something about the land of Eretz Yisrael. Lech lecha me'artzecha u'mimoyladcha u'mibeis avicha. Hashem tells Avram Avinu, go from your house, from your homeland, from your birthplace. Ela oretz asher areka, to the land that I will show you, the land of Eretz Yisrael. And you might think to yourself, yeah, of course, there's holiness in Eretz Yisrael. But what about all the secularization in Eretz Yisrael? There's so many irreligious Jews there. But what we need to remember is that every Jew is holy, every Jew is precious. And by being in the land of Eretz Yisrael, the holiness will somehow find you, even when you don't want it to. Listen to this beautiful and amazing story. There was a kibbutz, a very secular kibbutz, where they were not interested in Judaism at all. They wanted their children to have nothing to do with the Torah. 60 families, and they felt very strongly about it. Well, there was one girl, her name was Ilana Kochavi. And Ilana somehow, some way, started to explore and ask questions from her parents. Her father answered her questions, and even though he did not want her to become religious, that is the journey that she took. And he supported her journey somewhat, and eventually she became religious. And then eventually she found a young man, a Baal Tshuva, much like herself, who understood her situation, and they got engaged. And then she asked her chassan, would you be willing to have our chassan, our wedding, in my kibbutz? I loved where I grew up. And he, being the understanding individual that he was happy for her to have her chassan, her dream wedding, on her kibbutz. And so it was. Well, there were people that came from the neighboring kibbutz, but it wasn't so simple. I mean, after all, did this secular kibbutz want to have a religious wedding? Well, the father brought it to the other members of the board, and they agreed that it would be okay. There was a fellow from the neighboring kibbutz who on the night of the wedding had one too many drinks, and he approached the father, and he was very angry that she had become religious. And he said to the father, how'd you end up with such rotten kids? I mean, where'd it go wrong? Well, the father really was going to turn around and get back to the wedding, but he felt he wanted to share his story on this very special night. And he said, you know, I have a neighbor whose daughter went to her saba and savta, to her grandparents who were religious. And there was a sidur, there was a prayer book on the couch, and she opened it. Their granddaughter opened the sidur to, of all places, to Kriyat Shema. And she asked her grandmother what it was, and her grandmother knew not to preach religion to her. And she told her that it's a special prayer for protection. And she said, can I have the prayer book? Now this kibbutz, there were many Scud missiles that fell and other types of missiles. And unfortunately, there were attacks on the kibbutz. And when she got back, she said, you know what, I have a friend. And she went to her friend, my daughter, Ilana. And she said, Ilana, I have to show you something. And she went to a secret corner and she showed her the sidur and she said, look at this prayer. This special prayer is a prayer for protection. 60 families on our kibbutz. How about I say the prayer and you'll say the prayer? We'll each say it 30 times every night. And that's what they did. And what do you know? That was the last time that there was a missile attack on the kibbutz. And he looks at the drunken fellow and he said, so after it's all said and done, I'm very grateful to my daughter that she and her friend, who both became religious, they said this special prayer and they protected us. Now, if you don't mind, I got a wedding to go to. Well, holiness will find you. And of course, it can find you anywhere, but when you're in the land of Eretz Yisrael, in the holiest of lands, it's bound to find you even sooner.